Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends. Let us do one question of dissolution of partnership firm where we are having item of bank overdraft and reserve fund. How to deal with them? Let us understand. We'll read question. Ganesh and Chandan were partners sharing profits and losses in proportion of 3:2. They dissolved the partnership firm on 31st March 2011 when their position was as follows. Assets, debtors 112,500. These are gross debtors. Realization account debit. RDD, it will be transferred to realization account credit. Stock, realization account debit. Furniture, realization account debit. Motor car, realization account debit. Cash in hand, this will be recorded in cash account debit side. On liability side, we have sundry creditors, realization account credit. Bank overdraft, this will be considered as a separate liability. It will be transferred to realization account credit. Reserve fund. What is reserve fund? Reserve fund is an amount of profit kept aside for future use. This is accumulated profit. This will be divided at the time of dissolution and distributed among partners in profit sharing ratio. Capital account credit. Partners capital account Ganesh, Chandan. Partners capital account credit. These are the balances will be recorded on credit side of partners capital account. The assets realized as follows. Debtors 90,001. Stock 2,02,000. Goodwill 25,003. These are the actual assets sold and amount realized. So effect will be cash debit. Continue. The assets realized as follows. Debtors 90,001. Stock 2,02,000. Goodwill 25,000. These assets are sold. That is amount received. So cash debit. Realization account credit. Motor car was taken over by Ganesh for 70,000. Ganesh account debit. Realization account credit. Furniture by Chandan for 60,000. Chandan account debit. Realization account credit. The creditors were paid rupees 22,500 in full settlement. Creditors are 25,000. So we paid 22,500 in full settlement. Cash credit. Realization account debit. The difference 2,500 will not be recorded separately. It gets adjusted in realization account. The expenses of realization amounted to 10,000. Cash credit, realization account debit. Here they have not mentioned anything about bank overdraft. So we are required to assume and pay bank overdraft even if nothing is given in the question. Without payment of bank overdraft, dissolution will not be completed. Overdraft paid will have two effects. Cash credit realization account debit. For recording journal entries, there is no need to prepare ledger. We can do all journal entries except two, that is for profit and final amount paid to partners in settlement. Let us record all other journal entries by reading the question. On asset side, we have debtors, stock, furniture, motor car. This will be transferred to realization account. Entry will be realization account debit to various assets account. Realization account debit to debtors, to stock, to furniture, to motor car. Realization account debit 4,62,000 being assets transferred. RDD 12,500 will be transferred to realization account. Entries RDD account debit to realization account. RDD account debit to realization account 12,500 being RDD transferred. Cash in hand will be transferred to cash account. On liability side, we have sundry creditors, bank overdraft, which will be transferred to realization account. Sundry creditors account debit 25,000, bank overdraft account debit 20,000, to realization account 45,000 being liabilities transferred. Reserve fund 30,000, this will be distributed between partners in the ratio of 3:2. reserve fund account debit 30,000, to Ganesh capital account 18,000, to Chandan's capital account 12,000. Reserve fund is distributed. Being reserve fund distributed, we have completed your transfer stage of solving the problem. Next stage is realization of assets. That is, either assets are sold or taken over by partners. The assets realized as follows: debtors 90,000, stock 2 lakhs, goodwill 25,000. Cash bank account debit to realization account 90,000, being debtors realized. Cash bank account debit 2 lakhs to realization account 2 lakhs, being stock realized. Cash bank account debit to realization account 25,000, being goodwill realized. Motor car was taken over by Ganesh for ₹70,000. Your Ganesh account will be debited, realization account will be credited. Ganesh capital account debit 70,000 to realization account 70,000, being motor car taken by Ganesh. Furniture by Chandan for 60,000. Chandan capital account will be debited, realization account will be credited. Chandan's capital account debit to realization account 60,000, being furniture taken by him. The creditors were paid 22,500 in full settlement. Realization account debit to cash bank 22,500, being creditors settled. Bank overdraft, they have said nothing, but we have to assume that it is paid, and accordingly we are required to record an entry. Realization account debit to cash bank 20,000 being bank overdraft paid. The expenses of realization amounted to 10,000. Realization account debit to cash bank 10,000 being realization expenses paid. We have recorded all the adjustments. Now we are required to record the entries for realization profit or loss. For this purpose, all ledger accounts are not required to be open completely. We can prepare this as a working note. As a working note, we have opened realization account and partner's capital account. We are not going to record everything. We are going to focus only on amounts so that we can find out balancing figure of profit or loss and amount payable to partners on final settlement. Capital of Ganesh 2,30,000, Chandan 1,50,000, reserve fund 30,000 distributed in the ratio of 3:2. 18,000, 12,000. Realization account debit. Realization account debit 4,62,000 to various assets account. Realization account debit said 4,62,000. RDD debit to realization account 12,500. On credit side, 12,500. Sundry creditors 25,000. Bank overdraft 20,000. Realization account 45,000. Reserve fund to partners capital, we already considered this. Cash bank account debit to realization account 90,000. Cash bank to realization 2 lakhs. Cash bank to realization account 25,000. Ganesh capital account debit to realization account 70,000. This will be recorded to the debit of Ganesh capital 70,000, to the credit of realization account 70,000. Chandan's capital account debit 60,000 to realization account 60,000. Chandan's capital account debit 60,000, realization account credit 60,000. Realization account debit to cash bank 22,500. Realization account debit to cash bank 20,000. Realization account debit to cash bank 10,000. Now we have posted all information in journal entries and given in the question. Let us close realization account to find profit or loss. Let us find out profit or loss on realization account. We are required to match credit and debit total. Here we have considered only amounts in working note because we are interested to find out the balancing figure, which may be a profit or which may be a loss on realization. Realization loss is 12,000. This is divided between Ganesh and Chandan in the ratio of 3:2, that is 7,200 and 4,800. This will be recorded to the debit of their capital accounts. Ganesh 7,200, Chandan 4,800. Now we can close their capital accounts to find out the amount payable or amount receivable, as the case may be. Balancing figure of Ganesh 1,70,800, Chandan 97,200. These are the amounts payable to partners on final settlement. So we are required to record now two balance entries, that is entry for loss on realization and final settlement. Ganesh capital account debit 7,200, Chandan's capital account debit 4,800, to realization account 12,000, being realization loss transferred. Ganesh capital account debit 1,70,800, Chandan's capital account debit 97,200 to cash bank 2,68,000, being amount paid in final settlement. Thus, in this question, we have completed journal without preparing complete ledger. Thanks for watching this video. Stay in tune with Ikeda and subscribe to our channel Ikeda. Thank you.